channel, and in this video I'm doing a versus battle. I am using this deck, which is Snorlax Zoroark GX. Kind of a weird deck, but we are using Snorlax and Zoroark GX versus Archie's Blastoise. So, Zoroark Snacks. Sky Field, Triple Acceleration, Energy, do a bunch of damage. Snorlax, Zoroark, defend your cards, get a bunch of rich Pokemon. That's kind of the idea of the deck. This is Archie's Blastoise, where you just accelerate water energy with Deluge. Archie's just in the hole. Stuff like that. So now we are going to start setting up. I'm playing by myself. Oh, let me move this a little bit. You can see the deck. I don't have a mat with me, but this is kind of awkward when we're shuffling up, but sorry not for uploading these past days. I'm not uploading a long time.
I need to upload more, and I'm really sorry about that.
So I'm going to upload this video today, and I hope you enjoy it. That Snorlax Zoroark will win,
because if this deck doesn't get it turn one, it's probably not gonna win, because it needs to get it turn one.
Because when I've been playing, it doesn't always get it turn one,
because I don't have Shaman EX and stuff like that.
But yeah, try my best. I'll put the deck list in the description,
and I will also do deck profiles on them, because
I need to upload more. There, and we're gonna do the coin flip. This is the Blastoise coin.
I call Zoroark player call cards.
So Zoroark player chooses to go first, and that's your starting hand of seven cards. It's kind of awkward, but I guess.
Seven. And the
Archie's player is gonna draw his starting hand of seven cards.
Pokemon, and
we're just gonna see
prize cards. Right there. And we're gonna see if Zoroark
played from Pokemon, and he did, he found not see his, but gonna do his prize cards. And
we are off
with Zoroark, Snorlax, Zoroark, Jix, Zoroark, Ditto.
I mean, we're gonna see a pass. Quick turn for
him. Didn't have a very good hand. Seems like in his opponent's turn, gonna draw a card. They could get turn one Archies. Oh, they've got turn one Archies. They've got turn one Archies. Oh my gosh. Well, unless he prizes Archies in the hole. Hope he didn't. Archie's ace in the hole, and he's got a turn one Archie's ace in the hole. Archie's Blastoise, so we could see a very explosive turn for him this game. Let's do this Master Pile, draw Versus Seeker, and Dogmaster, exactly what you want.
Ultra So this deck does play the next score to one of your candy, but I think right now I'm going to discard that with Superior Energy Retrieval and Touch Energy with Seeker.
Yeah, the card, because I can always...
I run 4 Versus Seeker in this deck, so I can always Versus Seeker for Archer's Instant Hole again and get a Buster Shield. Buster Shield
is kind of like a game ender. Its Rocket Splash attack can do a ton of damage. I do have the promo art, but I like the promo art. I think it looks cool. And Rocket Splash
can one-hit KO anything, even a Snorlax from your
deck. Triple 7 energy from your deck, from your Pokemon into your deck. And he's going to discard it with the Superior Energy Retrieval. He's going to get one energy back to attach to Keldeo and Versus Seeker for Archie's Ace in the Hole. Attach to Keldeo Versus Seeker for the Archie's Ace in the Hole. Play the Archie's Ace in the Hole. Get the Blastoise from Boundary's Crest, I think, onto the bench. And draw him 5 cards. But he doesn't
have it this time. Look at these cards. Battle Compressor.
Blysander.
There was a Sycamore, and there was a Float
Stone. Which I attached to the Keldeo EX. So not very good cards.
So I think I just
have to pass it to my opponent. Who was very happy that I didn't bonk him for like a ton of damage. Because it was possible. It's a Mr. Mime. My opponent does not play any Pokemon with that Snape on the bench, so I might just
going to trade that away.
With 2 cards here. There's a Skyfield coming down.
Switch his bench by a lot. Where is he? Ultra Ball away, counter catch and triple acceleration
energy. Gonna be able to look through his deck.
See what he prizes with that.
He's gonna want the Denny GX or Tapu Lele. Well, he's got Tapu Lele in his deck. He's gonna probably want to grab the Denny GX. And since he's running for Ultra Ball and a lot of Pokemon search, he's probably gonna get Sonic Unix. Does have only one Snorlax VMAX in the deck. That's okay, how many triples does he have? 1, 2...
Okay, he has all triples.
Well, not really, but like, kind of. And we get the Denny GX coming down. A dead chance this time. But he is going to be able to play all the cards
in his hand. His cards in his hand work. Air balloon and a special charge, so you can put a triple service energy back into the deck and hopefully draw something like this dead chance. And if he doesn't, he can always find an ultra ball for a Tapu Lele with or an N, but actually he might not play N because I think he knows his opponent's
hand is bad. Well, he does because we're playing each other. I'm fighting myself, but we're trying to speak where we're playing like a different person. I'm trying to be a commentator, I don't know. Get up Prism Star, special charge, use triple acceleration energy back into the deck. And this deck only has about 6 attacks because of only triple acceleration energy. And I'll have special charge back, so maybe I could have saved it and gone to the Lele. But I decided not to, which could have been a bad play, but I think personally there, I just want to draw cards with the Denna and not play my supporter for the turn. That's just my opinion. Change for 6 cards. See if I can find something here. Okay. Well,
cards in hand.
I don't really want to end him.
I might wonder King for two. I do not want to give my opponent
a new hand because
their hand is looking good, so I'm going to wonder King.
Or Kate and Liza. Continue digging for stuff. I want to get an attack with this turn. And I do not think. I can always go for Mallow. Oh, Mallow would be a good play.
Zorak Snorlax is my best deck in Expanded anyway, because Arches Buster gives me a lot of cards. At times, it's not as consistent as like Zorak Snorlax, which is,
I think, a very consistent deck. That's just my opinion.
And the Mallow was right here.
That was a Mallow that fell out. It's kind of an awkward video, but I really hope you enjoy it. I love the Expanded format. I love it.
Like 1,000 more times than Standard. I think Standard
is just Dragapult. Well, that was like
3 months ago. Now
it turned as Vikavolt, City Scritch, stuff like that. I don't like that. I think it's just meta. But Expanded, there's like cool creative ideas. And I know some people don't like Expanded. It's like because they think there's like these busted combos like Trevenant and Dusknoir, Aggro. I don't know. And we're gonna see a knockout on this top.
I mean, Kildeo EX. Why
was I saying Tapu Deo? I do not know. But yeah, on Kildeo EX. I'm going to trade the EX. So at this point I teach you a bunch of Pokemon. I have 1, 2, 3, 4 bunch of Pokemon. 3 times 4. 30 times 4 is 120, plus 60 is 180, that knocks out Kildeo EX. So I get 2 prize cards. Barbicle is the least relevant card in this matchup. If you have a Stadium in play, that's why I run it. Your opponent
can't have special energy.
It's for Ultra Necrozma
and Snorlax VMAX mirror matches. That's why I kept it in.
And I took another Snorlax VMAX off the prize cards. It's my opponent's turn, and they're going to have to promote their Blastoise, which is not the deal for them. At all. The top deck. Water energy is not gonna matter.
I think you just Sycamore here.
I think he's eyeing up a lot of N's. Because N is very good in this matchup.
Skyla,
maybe. On Archie, but his opponent just tripled and knocked out the Kildeo EX. He had a Risk Seeker in hand so he could. He just had a Risk Seeker so he could end and his opponent's a 4, but that's not really an end of 4, it's really because he has Zorak in play, so. I'm just going to play Professor Sycamore.
He's going to draw
7 cards off the top of his deck.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
There's some other energy in this deck, so.
There's no
Pokemon out. One shot. Magic Carp and Waylord and Buster's hooked up, or I think prize for him, and yes they were, so he's gonna have to get Lapras V out of the deck, and he needs to switch the boss he has off. I think he has a switch now, so well, he has order pads, so he could get a flip stone. I'm pretty sure he wants an order pad for Ultra though. He's got Sene GX, but he could always get a flip stone. Head, so you can search a different item card. And what item card do you want here?
You want Ultra Ball.
Ultra Ball, so you can keep finding cards. And right now that's the most
important
thing. You can get 3 water energy and play this turn. And since he has so many water in the deck, you can probably find one off of Dedenne. And you can probably find the Plessy Letter. So he's going to get Ultra Ball. And hopefully he can find the Plessy. If he doesn't find a Float Stone, well, I think he needs to, like, deal some damage. And he's also going to get damage from another war price, so he didn't have a big attacker. And that's his bad.
Like
triple acceleration energy. So it's over. He's going to knock out the Blastoise. And right now, Zorak Snorlax is in complete control. Ultra Ball down here. I don't think he's going to need Stealthy Hood. GX. Touch the water and he's gonna play. I'm not very good at pronouncing stuff. Two water energy and he's gonna lock our feet and hopefully they can heal. Then his deck is very, very thin. He should take a lot of Nerf potions. Do a heal with Snorlax and Max. That would be awesome for him. To the lab last week, you play Battle Class, which is like in his deck more. Doesn't want to. This game, kind of on a fast clock. Because he knows his opponent has 4 triple acceleration, well, 3 triple acceleration energy in the deck. I mean, of course, it's a good thing, but they can probably find it, and he just doesn't want to get knocked out here. GX to draw him 6 cards.
Ooh, there's a
Hydro Pump does not fit the situation right now. He has 300 on the Lock Loss. Can't find a triple acceleration energy, because if they whiff this turn, then
they're back on track to
win. If they whiff this turn, top deck triple acceleration energy. Wow. Wow. It's another blast us in town. He
did not gonna be able to top deck it.
The opponent probably should have known that, but he didn't think they would top deck it. They only had three. He did not think they would top deck it. So now, he wants a versus secret. He wants that. He can't attach all these. There's the footstone. One turn late. He only did 210 damage here. He does not. So small, needs to find support. There's a double aqua patch. Oh, no support. Just a versus seeker. Opponent's not versus. He's probably, well, his opponent's gonna need to dig. I should have gotten him a Pokemon fan club. Just so surprised that they decided not to do anything. Probably should have gotten a Pokemon fan club right there. Pleasure gun for a fan club last turn. I think that messed them up. Now that I don't think it. Sky feels like a sky feel. I'm not gonna need that. I think his opponents. Might as well go for a fan club here. Gonna get some more Pokemon here that are helpful to him. Ludovudu. He's playing with Ludovudu. I don't know. I have to draw more cards here, I think. Once I get another Zerua, it looks like. Zerua, maybe? Double Zerua? I don't think he wants that. I don't think he wants it. Well, he could get Seal, but double Zerua sounds good. Zerua, maybe? And if he finds a triple acceleration energy here, I think it's over, really. I'm going to Dazzlewood. And right now has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 bunch of Pokemon. He's going to trade, it looks like. I know it's Zoroark. Not cards he really wants. He's going to put the air balloon on the Zoroark. Basic out, and there's that Absol. Doesn't need that Zerua. I think he's just trying to think of stuff here. I could have done double clash energy there. You can find a the 7 Pokemon's bench. It's going to do about 270 damage. Energy, and it's gonna pass it from his opponent. Now, if his opponent finds a way to get enough energy on Nexus and Nexus Max, it's gonna be hard for his opponent to win. Which I think he might go for. He's really wants to find a triple Zorich energy here. He can spin as much as possible to get a triple Zorich energy here. Or double clutch. If he gets a double clutch, he would like that a lot more because then he can doesn't have to discard it the next turn. Away, this looks like triple acceleration energy. Oh, double colors energy. For two prize cards, and I think his opponent lost it there. They can do two, and oh, they cannot get some. Have a good hand in a knockout. Max V Max for two.
Three prize cards.
Oh, they're all his attackers. If his opponent's on to one prize card, the opponent's gonna have to convert zero with air balloon. Has one double colors energy in deck. So a Zoroark with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Well, 8 Pokemon he has some on his hand. Middleman. Does he end himself here? Do you end yourself to one?
Yeah, you end yourself to one right now.
He's gonna play the end. Opponent had him. He knows his opponent, I think, has a good end. Take some prize cards. And the end of one is not bad because we have Oranguru, we have two Zoroarks, and it's disrupting my opponent. And it's my only supporter, so I can find more cards. Basically, if he finds double colors energy here, I think it's over. Because, well, there was no way his opponent would have won anyway. There are just the last, so it's gotten us out. The three prize cards. three cards right here. And what did he find? Ooh, a Sycamore and a Versus. Oh, he could get an Archie Easton Hole here. Those are some good cards. Now his opponent, gonna look at his one card. That's an Energy Lotto. Instruct first. Oh, there's a Mallow. He's smiling to himself. I think he prizes double, so he has one double colors in the discard and nothing else. I don't think he prizes double colors. If he did, that would be huge. He play Mallow as his supporter for the turn, does he have double colors?
Oh, I think he has double colors energy. I think
you
take an AZ
here. Line up AZ. V-Max. He has the V-Max in the deck, I think. He has the V-Max in the deck.
Just go for that and you'll get triple, maybe? This is a very intense match.
His opponent did get a good hand, did not know that, so that's why, well, know what I mean. Order.
Trade away
energy lord.
Probably the ultra. But the first energy lord trade. Right, just beating for it's like 160 damage. 100. Eight Pokemon play at 160 damage. Bloodbrush didn't earn it.
That was just. I think it ended probably a huge favor, but I did not know his hand. He's ace in the hole. Wait, could he knock out? Knock out the Zora GX. I don't know if there's a people of Ocean Loop. And the one prize card. But his opponent, well, his opponent's won the game. Oh, his opponent's won. This is easy. First can see it retreat. Zora triple. Good game to myself. So that was game one. We're only gonna do one game today because I don't know. I'm just gonna do one game today. I can always do game series. So what deck do you think is better? And well, Zora.
Zoroark Snorlax did win, but I've kind of made a misplay. I did not think I would top deck triple acceleration energy. Now, normally, you're not going to top deck a triple acceleration energy. It's not a high chance, but I happen to, so that kind of caused some stuff. And I think that both the decks are good. I think Zoroark Snorlax is really good because it's more consistent. You can set up a bunch of dudes. Like, I'm running like 23 Pokemon in the deck. I'm going to put the deck list in the description of this video. I hope you enjoyed the video. I'm really sorry not for uploading on some days, but I hope you enjoyed the video, and